Today, I want to tell you three stories. The first one comes from a journey I did to China this summer. We were exploring Beijing when we stumbled in a shop. Now, this shop sells particular food, and by the image you're shown, I can guess you already figured out what kind of food they were selling. They grabbed the scorpions alive and they fried them right in front of me. So we were kind of skeptical at first, but we were curious as well, so we decided to try them. They gave us two sticks with three scorpions each. The moment we tried them, our faces turned pale. We were also scared by the fact that they didn't even remove the tail. We didn't know they were poisonous, and we didn't know how to ask. It was really funny, you should have seen our faces. You see what I just did there? There's a reason why I told you this story. Mainly to start a conversation, yes, but also to show how useful it is to tell a story, especially a personal one. How we connect with people is always determined by what we tell, and showing a bit of our past is quite effective at that. I guess what I want to say is that all the lessons that I learned from life, like how useful it is to tell a story, or how you can see your past from a different point of view, or just how you can improve from your mistakes, I got these lessons stuck in my head because of the memories that I have and how I revisit them every now and then. Let me show you what I mean with my story. This one comes from Venezuela, and I promise no scorpions. This is a book that I got from my teachers back in 2010. They gave it to me because they thought they could give me something to remember about the place. What makes this book so special is what's on the first page. It's a collection of thoughts from every single teacher. Now, I think some context is needed. When I remember my childhood, I remember how lonely it was. How I struggled not only to fit in, but even to show up to school. It was a really tough time for me, and I don't remember it easily. However, some of the times, I try to think of something nice, and trust me, it is hard. But as soon as I start to think, this book is the first thing that pops up in my mind. And then all the good memories start flowing. By keeping this book close to me, I learned to face the past and get the courage that I needed. Because that's something that we need. We tend to forget pieces of our past because we're scared of them, they're not pleasant, we want to forget them. But the problem is we're just running away from them, they're gonna stay, and you can't do anything about it. Unless you want to improve on them. And just like how I learned to improve and face the past, so can you by revisiting your memories similar to these. There's one last story I want to tell. This one comes from Venezuela as well. I won these two medals at the school Olympics. Now, the first one I got it from a swimming race. But the second one is one I didn't quite deserve. Before I participated in the swimming contest, I decided to join my class's soccer team. I figured it could have helped me to fit in with the others, and I joined. So I decided to leave the team. But here's the thing. I forgot to cancel the subscription until the very last day of the Olympics, when they gave us our medals. Guess what? My team won, but without me. So I still got the medal. Their faces were full of hatred and disgust. Have you ever heard of the expression, live and learn? Well, there's a reason that exists. People grow from their mistakes. They learn how to interact with the world through the experiences of their past. And just like how I learned to remember my responsibilities, so can you by revisiting your past once in a while. The stories I just told you might seem like just that, stories, but they mean a lot. Not only because they make the person that I am today, but also because they determine my future actions and thoughts. And this logic applies to everyone, no exceptions. What we like, what we don't like, the people we hang out with, our sense of humor and so on. It is crucial then to treasure these memories and to remember them every time to become better human beings and hopefully make the